Hey everyone, and welcome back to the Mile High Nomads. If you've been following along, you know I've been teaching Bailey how to fly.
Before we get started, we just want to say a huge thank you to all the support you've shown us so far. It's really encouraging to see how many people want to follow along with our teaching videos. And for all our new viewers, please hit that like and subscribe button to watch and follow the journey of what it takes to become a certified private pilot.
Last time we covered the basics, pre-flight, checklist usage, and the four fundamentals of flight. And today we'll learn slow flight and stalls, and why it's so important to know these maneuvers.
Let's do this thing. Transponder, standby.
Transponder, yes, 1200 for VFR.
Flaps up.
Yeah, all right. Officially all right. Confirmed they're up.
Back to neutral.
And then we're gonna set our barometric pressure to the altimeter setting we just received.
3002.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, what's the next step? I think we can make a move. ATIS we have, and then yeah, we can taxi. So there's one in short final right there. Open traffic, 80117, taking off runway 35, departing to the east, open. Okay, you grab the yoke. I'm on the rudders, and at 55 we have airspeed, everything in the green, pull. Pull, pull, pull.
Open traffic, executor 5-0-5-6.
Okay, and keep her at about 10 degrees.
Yep.
Okay, one hand on the throttle. Okay, push a little bit. Yeah. Left. We're gonna stay under blue heading cloud.
Okay.
Nice job. Okay. Level out, so straight and level, airspeed to 90, take out some power and trim. I don't know what he's doing, he's following us.
Is he air police?
Yeah, I don't know, it's just really annoying. Because he doesn't get out of our way, so we're gonna...
Is that plane out of our way?
No, he's still really close. November... Are you on channel?
Yep, we got you guys in sight. We're doing a simulated engine out. We're steering clear, you guys.
Gotcha, thank you. They didn't make any radio calls. They didn't make... They just started the maneuver. And this is...
Position report.
Yeah, in CHEPS. Your controls.
My controls.
All right, so everything is set up. We're gonna start with some slow flight. So slow flight is what we do when we come in for landing, for example. We're cruising, right? Like we are at nearly 2400 RPM, we're at 105 knots, 3000 feet. What will we do now if we wanna gain altitude? What would you do?
So nose up and then put more power.
Yeah, so basically we do our altitude, we change our altitude with pitch. So if we want to gain altitude now, we pull up the nose. If we want to get rid of altitude, if we want to descend, we push the nose down. When we're in slow flight, it doesn't work anymore. Then we control our airspeed with our pitch. So if we want to speed up, we bring the nose down a little bit. If we want to lose some airspeed, we bring the nose up a bit. So we call that the region of reversed command. So let's get into slow flight. And we're gonna do slow flight. I'm gonna go through it with you.
Okay,
so
show me first and then.
Yeah. And what did I write on your notepad?
Clearing turns.
Yeah.
Heading, airspeed, altitude, position report, setup, configure, start.
All right. Southeast practice area, 80117, 2 miles southwest, Black Diamond, 3,000 foot, doing slow flight, southeast. And now we're gonna get into, so now we set up and configure. So we're gonna do full flaps, and our flap speed, maximum flap speed is 85 knots. So we're gonna pull power, and I'm gonna pull the nose up because we don't wanna lose altitude. And below 85, there we go. Now all our flaps in, I'm gonna give it some power back. And now we're gonna stay at altitude. We're gonna try and go as close to the stall horn as possible. Gonna have to trim a little bit. The plane becomes really sensitive right now. So now, like I said, if I pull up now, I'm not gonna gain any altitude. I'm just gonna slow down. So we're in the region of reverse command. So with my pitch, so if I wanna speed up, I bring the nose down and we speed up, you see?
Yeah.
If I wanna slow down, we bring the nose up and we slow down.
Okay.
We're gonna gain some altitude. I probably need to go full power. I need a lot of right rudder because we're in a high power setting and slow airspeed. You see, we now start climbing and I do that. And if I pitch up, we straight away are gonna slow down.
So what's the point of slow flight? That's just when you're about to do a landing?
Yeah, so you're in slow flight when you land and you need to get a feeling of how the plane is reacting, because I can give you the controls, one hand, and small corrections. It's gonna be super sensitive. One hand on the throttle. So we're at 3000, so take some throttle out. Yeah, just pull a little bit more until you hear the engine, like, yeah, that's, oh, put some back in. I don't want to get too slow. If you don't have enough power, because what do we control with our power in the region of reverse command?
Your altitude.
Altitude, very good. So we want to be at that sweet spot that we don't descend and don't and also not climb.
Okay.
Which we are pretty well set now. Oh, yeah. You feel how sensitive the plane becomes?
Yeah.
Okay, take out some power because we're climbing.
Leaving altitude.
And we're gonna go make a 180. Very slow turn.
This is way scarier than...
This is slow flight. And keep that turn going. You're doing really well. Just small corrections and just bring us to that heading bug. We're maintaining altitude pretty well. We are a little fast. So how do we control our airspeed again?
Nose up.
Yes. So just a little bit up.
Okay.
And get 2 watts that, like, try to stay below, between 55 and 50.
My heart rate is being tachycardic right now. Okay, I'm just about at heading.
Yeah, we're losing some altitude, so how do we fix that?
Throttle.
Yeah, so okay. We're descending a little bit, so just give it some more throttle.
A little more power.
And also pitch up a little bit because we wanna stay below that 55. And as soon as we hit at 3000, you can take that power out again.
3000. Okay, take power out. I wanna do it like a steering wheel.
No, we learn, like, if it's funny if you think about it, because we can't even write our name with our left hand. but we fly planes with it. Southeast practice area, Skyhawk 80117, 3000, about 3 miles northwest of Enumclaw, doing power off stalls. Southwest, southeast. Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna induce a stall. My controls.
Your controls.
So this is a landing stall, a power off stall. So basically, when this will happen is you come in for landing and then we round out and then we flare.
Yeah.
If you would pull too much during a flare, because by the time we have power to idle, like we have no throttle in anymore, and you put, like, basically pull the nose up too high, you will stall the plane. And if it stalls at such a low altitude, you will crash.
Okay.
So that's why we, like, the whole point of this maneuver is recognizing it and basically fixing it before it is too late. So power off stall. We are in landing configuration. Flaps are out. So we pull the throttle. We're gonna get into a descent. Pick up some speed. About 60, and now we're gonna pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up. Stay coordinated, pull up, pull up. there's the stall horn, and there's the stall. And first notch of flaps out, and positive rate of climb.
Approaching.
Second
altitude.
Notch of flaps out. Get to VY, 74, all flaps out, and we're climbing back from the ground. How was that?
That's crazy.
Okay, so that was a power off stall. So we just did a clearing turn. I'm gonna bug my heading again. Let's go to the gap. So that's a stall that we use. That's a stall that will happen during a landing. But we also have takeoff stalls. And that's what we call a power on stall. So a power on stall is with our flaps up and it's during takeoff. So basically when someone just pulls up too much during a takeoff and you stall. So that's gonna be a full power. That's usually a bit harder to induce, at least with this specific plane. We're gonna go till our rotation speed. Do you know what rotation speed is? Do you remember? When do we start pulling when we take off?
55.
55. So we're gonna go try not to gain any altitude. So I keep pulling. We're gonna bleed out a lot of airspeed. I don't wanna gain altitude. 55, or at least close to 55. There we go. Full power. There's the stall horn.
Leaving altitude.
And it doesn't make a full stall. But what we do is we bring that nose down a little bit, continue to climb, pick up that airspeed. So that was a power on stall.
That's not as scary as a power off stall.
You want to try a power off?
All right, right about there.
All right, so we are 3300. So we're going to do 3300 for our altitude bug. So what we're going to do is you're going to pull back power, yeah, all the way.
Yep.
Okay, keep the nose up. And below 85, we're gonna dump our flaps. So dump all your flaps,
all
yeah. All right, and then add power.
All the way?
That we stay at altitude. So what we're gonna do is we're in slow flight, the flaps are out, we're coming in for landing. We're gonna pull our power because we're about to touch down. Then we're going to start our descent by pushing the nose down. We're going to gain a little bit more airspeed, so we're going to push the nose down till about 60 knots.
60.
As soon as you hit 60 knots, we're going to pull up and we're going to keep pulling up. Like up, 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 until the plane like stalls. So you felt it drop, right?
Yeah.
As soon as that happens, you're going to bump in, like push in all that power straight away. Bang, one notch of flaps out.
Okay.
I'll help you.
Okay.
Okay, so pull that power. We're gonna descend, till about 60 knots, and then we're gonna pull up. So don't go too fast, it will get there. Yeah, and now pull up, pull up, pull up, pull, 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 more, more, more. And there's the stall, full power. There's the secondary stall, so that's why we don't pull up straight away, and we take out one notch of flaps. And we need to get a positive rate of climb. Positive rate of climb, pick up that airspeed, take a notch of flaps, and go to our VY, 74, and take the rest of the flaps out. How is that for a sensation?
That's terrifying. I just want to know who's the first person to ever do that and was like, oh, thank God it worked.
Hub and traffic, 80117, 8 miles to the east, will overfly the field to maneuver into the left downwind 35. So, do you know how far, do you know the altitude of a traffic pattern?
1,000 feet off the ground.
Yeah. So if we want to overfly the field, for example, to check the windsock or just to maneuver into the downwind, we do that at another 500 feet above the traffic pattern. So now we're going to do that at 1500. Hub and traffic, 80117, just joined the left downwind, 35, full stop, Auburn. And as soon as we turn, Auburn traffic, 80117, turning left base, runway 35, full stop, Auburn. And then one notch of flaps.
20.
Yeah, perfect. And then as soon as we're in the final turn, we're gonna do the last notch of flaps.
Okay.
Harbor traffic, 80117, turning final, 35, full stop, Harbor.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like and subscribe button so you don't miss the next lesson, where again, we're gonna take it a little step further.
Thanks again for flying with us, and we'll see you in the next one. Fly safe.
Fly safe.